How is he?
The guy's already gone, but he won't stop.
What's going on? Huh? Wasn't he stable after surgery? I had you watch over him. What happened?
Director, after the accident, he was trapped in the car for over an hour. His leg was stuck and he suffered acute spleen failure. It's too late. No one could save him. Enough. Enough!
Is he dead? Doctor, am I gonna die? Please save me.
Don't worry. I'll do the best I can, huh? All you need to do is get some rest so your wounds can heal, okay? Please take care of him.
Dr. Chong, let me do it.
Please get some rest.
I promised my son that I'd be there for his birthday, Doctor. You have to save me. Please save me, Doctor.
Don't worry. I promise you'll be there for your son's birthday. All right?
Don't leave. You have to save me. I made a promise to my son.
Chong, I thought you said you don't want to be a doctor. Why are you doing this right now?
Did you see Dr. Chong a while ago? Even an iron heart can melt.
You just wanted to do him a favor so you could bribe him later. So that when you ask for time off or a leave, he'll have no choice, right? Come on, just admit it.
It's not true. Why would you assume that I'm like that? I'm a sincere person. What would you have done anyway?
You.
Hey, what was that for? How dare you make those sounds in a place like this? Don't you guys get creeped out?
Oh, you get creeped out too? So why were you showing off today? If you did it, we wouldn't even be here.
Right.
But why would I show off, huh? For girls like you, this place may be a little intimidating. But for a man like me, it's just like going to the gym or grabbing a bite in the cafeteria. So how does that poem go again? Swiftly like the wind I came. Nobody cares. Now swiftly I go like the wind, and I wave goodbye. Nobody still cares.
Xiaochan, don't be scared. I'm pretty sure we won't die of fright here. In fact, the only thing I'm scared of is this guy fainting right here.
What's that supposed to mean? I'm just expressing myself in an artistic way, I'm telling you. I'm not scared of this place at all, come on.
Then why are your legs shaking like that? And then you tell us you're not scared? You're not fooling anyone here.
It's because I'm really tired.
We're here.
Why don't you two knock? What's the caretaker's name?
Xiaochong, you're such a coward. Just go there and talk to him.
I heard Miss Lin say that his name is Hobo.
Hobo. Go.
Hobo?
Wow. I had a lot today.
quite busy.
Why does he have to look like that? He looks like he just popped out of a coffin.
Shut up.
All right. Come on. Bring him inside. What are you waiting for? You must be new here. Don't you know the rules? You have to sign him up. Come on, don't just stand there. Go. Hurry. There. Hush. There. You two hold the door for him. Come on. Push.
Hurry up, guys.
This way.
So don't leave me alone here.
There you go.
Dad, why did you leave us? We can't live without you. We need you, Dad. What'll happen now?
Okay, bring him in. Okay, just a moment. Oops, already taken. Son, you're a new intern, aren't you? Is it your first time? Are you scared? Don't worry, that's normal. Hey, son, come. Let's go to my quarters. Have a drink to calm your nerves. What do you think? Come with me. And the girls can come, too. Come on. Young man, hurry up! Young man, come in. Don't be shy. Here. Have a drink. It'll help. Go ahead. It will calm your nerves, son. Alcohol makes the blood warm. When the blood is warm, you'll feel brave. Go on, try it. How do you feel? A lot braver?
Hobo, whenever you work here alone, don't you feel scared at all?
Scared of what? You get used to it, in time. Do you want a shot? It'll help.
Intern anymore. I want to go home.
I want to go home too. So many dead people. I can't stand it.
Hey, I've been a caretaker here for 30 years. I've seen students like you, those who cry, those who faint. There's some students who even wet their pants. You know what? You guys aren't bad at all. Cry. Go ahead. You'll feel a lot better, okay?
Hobo.
What?
Today's our very first day as interns. And we saw three people die. I don't know if I can do this kind of work. It's too much.
Come here. Come on and have a seat. Sit down. Go on. Go, have a seat. Come on.
Hobo.
Yes?
You've worked here for many years. And it seems like you never get scared anymore. We've seen everything in the dissection lab, but today we saw three people die. And for the three of us, it was just too much to handle. How are you able to stay in this job, and how do you do it?
She's right.
Seeing all those people die today was hard. Do you think one day we'll end up in one of those compartments? I'm scared. I don't want that to happen to any of us, Xiaochan.
Well, I completely understand your situation. Technically speaking, as interns, you've seen everything in the dissection lab, huh? But you see, the hospital is a whole different ballgame. The specimens you use in the lab don't have blood anymore. But the people in the hospital, well, they still have a lot of blood left in them. So what's blood? It's the very essence of the heart, and the very essence of life. Blood is like our soul, and when our blood is gone, so does our soul, just like that. So remember, what's important is not to try to be a warm-hearted person, but do your very best to be a warm-blooded person as well. Blood fills our heart, but warm blood makes a warm heart. So try to be strong and keep your blood warm. Don't forget that. It's very important for doctors like you. You can't be cold towards people, especially if you want to be doctors. If you do this, you will go very far. So remember, a lot of people are counting on you. If you have genuine concern for others, you will become great doctors someday.
I get it now. Hobo, your words were so inspiring. I will never forget that. I'm going to be great. A warm-blooded doctor.
Hey, you're here. Why don't you take a rest?
All right, let's go.
Okay, I'll be back.
Wait!
Ouyang?
What's wrong? Do you have a problem with me?
No, it's just that... Wait. Where's Wang Bo?
He went to the bathroom. You didn't notice him.
I'm sorry I reacted that way, okay?
Chengzhan.
Yeah?
I just wanted to say thank you. Even though nothing might happen between us, I still want to thank you, and also for bringing me cake.
You're really something. You know that I had a bad day, and you're here telling me I'm a good guy?
I really mean everything I said, do you know that? You think I'm joking?
Just right now, the last thing I need is sympathy. I let him down. No amount of comforting we'll bring that guy back.
Oh. I won't comfort you, but I'll stay with you.
Yeah. When I was looking at that man, I stood there holding the drip for an hour. I felt like my whole body had gone numb. I thought that I was going to save his life, but in the end...
Chengzhan, I know you're a good person, but whatever you run into, suddenly, boom, your blood's 100 degrees. When you were saving someone, or when you bought me a birthday cake, you got really impatient. Being hot-tempered will not always be the best solution for everything. And some things will not always go your way.
Do you think that I'm a very immature guy? Is that the reason why you don't like me?
There you go again.
Ouyang, I've always wanted to know the reason why you won't give me a chance. You always say there's someone else, but where is he? I've worked with you for 2 years, and there's nothing. Aside from work, you spend all your time studying and almost never go home. And on your birthday, no one even buys you dinner or nice flowers. I really want to know who this person is.
The moment you see him, you'll know. I don't want to talk about it.
You're lying. Am I right? I know you don't like the ER. And you want something better. Since I'm an ER guy, you think I'll always be here. You want to weigh down your options. That's why you won't consider me. Am I right?
I don't need to explain anything. If that's what you think, then go ahead.
I'm sorry. I got carried away. Please forgive me.
It's fine. But you got one thing right. I don't want to stay in the ER.
Forget it. Let's just leave it at that.
Let's go inside. There's a lot of patients.
Right. Hey, what happened there? Where did all this blood come from? And there's blood all over the seats, huh? What's wrong, Ouyang?
Everyone says I'm ice cold, and that I'm heartless. But like you, I get scared too, you know? When that guy was lying on the ground, all covered in blood, and his eyes full of fear. I was really scared. I was scared that I won't be able to save his life.
Be my girlfriend, and I'll never let that happen again.
If you talk like that ever again, forget that I'm your friend.
Ouyang, just let me kiss you. Just this once. Here. It's like putting a period in our relationship. From now on, we can only be friends. No way! I'm telling you, Ouyang, I won't give up, and I'll be back!
What did you see in me anyway?
A box of liquor.
And one box of milk.
Auntie, we'll take all of this. Please put it in a box for us.
Oh my, and you all smell like alcohol. What have you been up to? And you girls, did you let yourself get drunk?
Oh, Aunt, it's only because we're really, really, really happy today.
And it's not only because we're happy, it's because we're new interns, yeah. And today's our first day. Mm-hmm. And in fact, we even saw 3 people die, and we're really scared.
Your total's 320.
Pay up.
Thank you, Auntie!
Auntie, here.
See you later.
Come on, let's go.
Please be careful. Mm-hmm. And
I'll
go easy on the alcohol.
We will.
Have a good night.
Ding, ding, dong, 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 dong
I'm not scared of anything at all! It's just a few dead people! Who cares? I'm not scared anymore! Hello to everyone! When you update your blog, put me in it! And remember, I'm going to be called Dr. Miracle. I'm Dr. Miracle!
Xiao Chong! Whether you stay or not, we'll stay. We won't go anywhere. We're in it forever. Forever! Forever!
Forever!
Look at you. Do you know what time it is? Do you realize how silly you look? I'm going up. Come on, we better go.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains.
You raise me up to what stories.
Hi, Mom. Why are you calling me so early?
Lulu, are you done with work?
Almost. I'll just take a shower first.
My goodness, you're so busy every day. So anyway, about Jinke, what did you think? Should I set something up for you too?
Oh, come on, Mom. You don't even know him that well. You don't have to bother.
Someone has to care about your future husband. Why don't you just let your own mother deal with it?
Mom, I'm not interested in him, so don't push the issue.
You don't like him? Then forget about it. I thought he was a bit arrogant myself. But, kidding aside, I'll tell you this. I saw one of your colleagues at the office yesterday. His name was... Right, his name was Cheng Jun. I think he's a very nice guy. He's very down-to-earth and he seems kind. And he looks very dependable. He's nice. What do you think? But wait, you're together every day. Are you already dating each other?
We're not together. I need to shower. I'll talk to you later, all right?
You take a shower together? My goodness! So you're a couple! You didn't even tell me that. Wait. What? Showering together? Oh my.
There. You know what I hate the most?
What?
No matter how long I wash my hands every day, I still can't get the stench of other people out right away.
I don't know. It doesn't even bother me that much. Wait a sec. Do you think you have OCD?
Wait. Who says that I can't have OCD, huh? If Ouyang says something like that, she's a princess. If I say something about it, I'm a complete wuss. Oh, wait. Chum, I almost forgot. I saw you two in the garden last night. What's up? Huh?
Nothing.
Do you think I'd believe that nothing happened between you two? Yesterday was intense. It was a very emotional day, and you even met her mother. And you had a deep conversation, and nothing happened.
Well, I hugged her.
You hugged her? Mm. For real? Mm. But is that all you got? Oh, I know that you wanted to kiss her goodbye, right? No kiss, but there's a hug. Is that some sort of etiquette? I'm telling you, man, that's it for you. Game over. Just find someone else. You know what? We've got two interns right now. One for you, and one for me. Sounds good?
No
way.
Come
on.
One for you? Which one? Who?
The sassy one.
Zhu Yimeng?
Good guess. She's mine.
Wait a minute. Did you catch her eye on the first day? You don't believe in love at first sight.
Look, man, why are you so dumb? You know when you meet the right person, whether it's for a whole day or just a second, you just fall in love. It's as simple as that, huh?
All right, look. She's all yours, man. Go ahead, huh?
So I've got your word? Hot.
Thank you.
Ding Ding! I'm begging you, please wake up, Ding Ding!
I'll be right back.
Go on.
Paging Dr. Chung.
Dr. Chung, here. This child was being transferred from a hospital in Hebei and she went into shock. It was caused by acute meningitis. And now she's unconscious. She needs help immediately. These are her lab reports.
Nurse, is that Ning Ning's doctor?
Yes.
Let's talk to him.
Doctor! Ma'am.
Ma'am, please stand
take
up.
Take it easy. Please relax.
Don't cry.
She's only 17.
Ma'am, stand up.
We can't
ma'am.
Live without her.
Come on,
please.
Get up. Please relax.
Please relax,
we
ma'am.
Both
it's going to be all right.
From home the whole year and only our youngest child lives with us, doctor. Ning Ning stays with her aunt and we only see her during New Year's. A few days ago, we got a call from her aunt that she's sick. And that's why we rushed back to see her and she was already like this. She's not waking up and we don't know what to do. Please save her daughter. Don't let her die. Please
doctor,
save her daughter.
I'm begging you.
Ma'am, come on. Get up. Her. Please, relax. Ma'am, you have to understand. This will not help anything. You have to calm down. Don't worry. We'll do the best we can.
Ma'am,
please
relax,
all right? Let me check her. Calm down.
How is she? Dr. Ayan, here are her reports. Her lymphocyte count is high.
What's wrong, doctor? Is she okay?
Let me explain it to you. Your child's condition is pretty severe. But first, you have to prepare yourselves, okay? We're just about to switch shifts. And soon, the director will be here to take a look. We'll do our best, so please, don't worry too much.
All right, doctor. Good. We'll trust you on that.
Good.
Chen Jian.
Director.
How is she?
Director, here's the report.
This girl has severe meningitis. She went into shock while being transferred. They brought her here.
Run her under a CT scan and check the results. We will do our best, so please, try not to worry. I'll see you later.
Let's go.
Thank you, Director.
We'll take care of her.
Yes. Thank you. Uh-huh.
Switch shifts.
Hey, once we're off, just give me your keys. I'll get your car washed.
It's fine. I'll do it myself. Thanks.
Hey, wait.
Director.
I need your attention. Everybody, please be quiet. Good. Where are the interns?
Huh? I don't know. Where are they? What?
Why ask me? You're the team leader, right?
Hurry, guys!
It's your fault. I think we drank too much.
What else can we do anyway?
Stop bickering. We're already late.
Slow down. I'm so tired. Dr. Ouyang?
Dr. Wang.
Dr. Chung, why are you guys here?
Well, we're here to greet the new interns, of course. The three of you are the rising stars in the field of medicine. If we don't serve you well now, when your time comes someday, it'll be hell for us. Besides, we're only here to look after you. Am I right? Wow, Dr. Zhao. It seems like you didn't hold back at all, right?
Dr. Chung, I'm so sorry, but I don't know what to say.
Dr. Ouyang, to be honest, we just drank a little
bit. That's fine. If that's not enough, we'll buy you some more, so you can keep drinking. How's that?
No, no, that's not what I meant. We'll never drink again.
We really didn't mean to do it. Because yesterday, when we went to the morgue, we got really scared. We were so shocked. And then Hobo gave us a drink to calm our nerves. He said alcohol can make the blood warm. If your blood's warm, you can be a good doctor. So we drank some alcohol. I'm sorry.
I screwed up.
We screwed up.
All right, that's enough. Just make sure it won't happen again. Go get changed now. The director is waiting. Just go. We went through the same thing as interns, didn't we? Come on, admit it.
So anyway, as I was saying...
Director,
we should... Please sit down. Everyone's waiting.
How is that then? I remember when I was an intern.
I'll just say a few words to all of you here. Yesterday's job was a tough one, and we made a few mistakes. So listen, because you learn a lot from this. The key to success is learning from mistakes. You must be attentive. The resident doctors must be active and oversee everything. The interns have to be aware. Everyone should be focused and determined to do each other's tasks. You understand? We can't let other things affect us in our jobs. We must do our very best to give the best possible service. You have to stay focused. It's important that we stay dedicated, so no matter how busy or stressed we are, we won't be affected. Always remember that we're not only doing this for them, but also for ourselves. We are doing all this work to become better. As for the new interns in this room, you should never settle for mediocrity, okay? And be an advantage to your team. You have to be very diligent, and you must give respect to your superiors. That's an important trait you must have in order to survive in this cutthroat world. Every doctor should have these set of skills in order to succeed in this field. You must remember, a doctor should have an ability to diagnose a disease correctly. And good communication skills. He should know how to talk to patients. A doctor should have the ability to work with a group. Teamwork is important. You are given this opportunity, so don't waste the gift that this career can give you. Remember, you are saving lives. If this was a battlefield, the doctors will be in the front lines.
We're in a meeting. What is it?
Oh. I'm here for Dr. Zhang.
For what? I'm Liu Chengsheng, and I'm a post-grad from nursing.
I'm here for my internship. The office sent me here.
All right, come in.
Thanks.
Dr. Zhang, an intern.
So you're Liu Chengsheng?
Yes.
I heard that you're the only male nurse in the class of 24, is that right?
Uh-huh.
Shouldn't you be an obstetrician, huh?
Dr. Zhang, please don't embarrass me here. Besides, I'm not the first male nurse, and males have more strength, and we can lift patients much easier. And also for some conditions like catheters and stuff, well, aren't I a better choice?
Miss Lin, did you hear that? Huh? This guy's all yours now, okay? If you need to put catheters or lift patients, just send for him.
What's the status of the patient?
We have to run several tests on her and check her blood count in the next few hours. Please update me on the results.
Dr. Ouyang hated me enough to begin with, and now she hates me even more. What can I do to change her opinion of me and make things better for my reputation?
You know, for some women like Ouyang who only live for their career, there's really nothing else you can do.
Hey, you know what? Dr. Chang must have been asking for trouble. After bringing such a huge cake here, only to be ignored.
He's been courting Ouyang for 2 years. But he's still got no progress. Too bad.
Nurse Dian, I heard you say Dr. Chung has courted Ouyang for 2 years. Is that true?
Well, of course it's true. Didn't you see yesterday for her birthday?
He got her a cake as a surprise. He had it sent to the office.
And then what?
I don't know what happened after that. But then the director found out and he scolded him. And no one ate the cake.
They put it in the fridge. What a waste, right?
And then what was Dr. Ouyang's reaction?
Everybody expected it. She was pissed.
Hey, wait a minute. You're an intern. You shouldn't gossip. Get to work.
Hey, did you hear that? Dr. Cheung has liked Ouyang for 2 years.
So what? Come on. Wherever you go, you always love to gossip.
I'm not gossiping for the sake of it. I'm doing it for my internship. If I want to get Ouyang to like me, I have to know her secrets. I have to get to know her better. You won't believe it, but I just got a really good idea. You want to know it?
You don't even have to say it. I really think Dr. Ouyang doesn't like him. Imagine he's been courting her for 2 years and still nothing. Just imagine you're in her position and there's this guy who likes you. And still, no matter what he does, you still don't like him. Imagine how horrible that must be and how annoyed she is of his actions. If you want to help Dr. Cheung in this problem, and you have to make Dr. Cheung give up on her. But take my advice and stay out of it.
What are you talking about? That's crazy. You're the kind of person who acts innocent but is always thinking bad of others. Just like how you came up with such a big theory like that.
Don't judge me, okay? I'm just helping you solve this problem. Take it or leave it. You have to admit, you're thinking the same thing.
I wasn't thinking the same thing.
What were you thinking
then? I was thinking about the cake.
Go ahead with your rounds.
Are you done for the day?
Yes.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.
Happy birthday, Doctor.
Happy birthday.
Since you're not going to eat the cake Dr. Cheung brought, rather than let it spoil, we gave it to the patients. They love it very much. Don't worry. Only those allowed got a slice. It was the intern's idea. She said that if more people gave you birthday wishes, you will be happier. Well, I think it's a great idea, Doctor.
Okay.
This is Dr. Ouyang's birthday cake.
What about me?
You're pretty bold. How dare you say that? You just started here, and you're late. Not to mention you were drunk. Do that again, and you're in big trouble.
Well, I'm so sorry. Dr. Cheung,
what?
You're done with your shift. Does that mean I can also...
You want to leave? I'm done with my shift. Look, go and see Director Ma and Mrs. Lin. You're going to be with them today, all right?
Hey! Sir!
Quick, the stretcher.
Right.
Please wake up. Sir, please. Can you hear me? Nurse Jan, my uniform.
Yes.
You're done with your shift, right? Why are you back?
Another one. Great. Get his temperature.
Okay.
Rattled breathing. Open an IV chat. Saline, 500 ml. Blood test, oxygen analysis, an X-ray. Hurry, to the ER.
Go, go, go.
我爱的宣言，请让我陪在你的身边，在爱爱你的世界 Love forever。
爱，如果我看不见，如果我听不见，如果我不了解，怎么会感受那么强烈，感受那么直接，拥有那感觉。
想之间靠近一点，温暖也多一些，我发现爱没有白天黑夜，我相信真爱会永远，是心跳是直觉，爱的信念不会熄灭，勇往直前不顾一切。
如果时间只剩一天，我还会为爱勇敢一点，再爱一天，再爱一遍，紧紧拥抱这个世界。如果心跳可以听见，就能听懂我爱的宣言，请让我陪在你的身边，再爱爱你的世界 Love forever。
爱，原来我看得见，萦绕在我耳边，像梦一样盘旋，我的心感受那么强烈，感受那么直接，拥有那感觉。
肩靠近一点，温暖也多一些，发现爱没有白天黑夜，我相信真爱会永远，是心跳是直觉，爱的信念不会熄灭，勇往直前不顾一切。
如果时间只剩一点，我还会为爱勇敢一点，再爱一天，再爱一遍，紧紧拥抱这个世界。如果心跳可以听见，就能听懂我爱的宣言，请让我陪在你的身边，在你的世界。如果时间只剩一点，我还会为爱勇敢一点，再爱一天，再爱一遍，紧紧拥抱这个世界。如果心跳可以听见，就能听懂我爱的宣言，请让我陪在你的身边，在爱爱你的世界 Love forever。